More than 1.2 million students dropped out of high school last year. It works out to one every 26 seconds. It's a big, complicated problem. Fixing it will take teachers, administrators, students, parents, politicians, and business. Joining me now to talk about it, Ed Rust, CEO of State Farm, the insurance company, former West Virginia Governor Bob Wise, now president of the Alliance for Excellent Education, and Dominique Farrar, who almost dropped out of school twice, but is still in school. Dominique, welcome to the program. Your friends call you Domino, right?
Yes, they do, Domino.
So tell me, you went through this program 26 seconds, yes. And you thought about dropping out a couple of times,
yes.
But you stayed in.
Yes, I did.
What did it mean to you? Why did you decide to stay in?
Well, at first, when I was preparing to drop out at the Agricultural Food and Science Academy, I just wasn't interested in school. I wasn't interested in the traditional, how you say, just traditional
right.
academics. And when I was enrolled in the High School for Recording Arts, I began to actually become more focused in academics and in graduating until things got rough with my daughter and whatnot, paying child support.
Right.
So
you're 19 years old and
yes,
you're a dad.
Yes, ma'am.
So like many people who are considering dropout, yes. you are a grown-up and you're a kid at the same time.
Right. Well, yeah. What kept me in school was, it was random actually. I came to the school one day and one of the facilitators, he's like the big brother facilitator,
right.
Dario, he was talking about the 26-second campaign. And when he said every 26 seconds somebody drops out of school.
And that was going to be you.
Yeah, exactly. So it was like, kind of smacked me in the face. Like, I don't want to be a statistic. I want to be, and plus being a recording artist, I want to, you know, set an example. I want to be someone that everybody looks up to. You know what I mean?
What about an example for your daughter as well?
Because
there's
definitely.
Also this dropout cycle that's very difficult to
right.
break, you know? I mean, you are a role model.
Right. And being a role model for my daughter is like, I don't want her to fall into a statistic that could grow. Like, it could become every 10 seconds somebody drops out. You know what I mean? I don't want it to.
So let me ask each of you, just quickly, you know, what works? Is it mentorship? Is it money for college? Is it higher expectations from the people around you? What works? What worked to keep you in school?
It's really self-motivation. Like, after you hear about the statistic, after you see the people around you are trying to help, now it's all up to the students. It's up to us as the students to actually take an effort to, you know, go ahead and graduate high school, be you.
Governor Wise, what works? Is it a little bit of everything?
It's a little bit of everything, but let me just say it's targeting. We know as early as sixth grade what students are on the dropout track. We can intervene. You can tell from drop in grades, you can tell from increased truancy, and you can tell from disciplinary
problems.
What
happens to those kids?
What happens is they don't wake up one day and drop out. It's a process that's taking place over many years. We also know this. We know that about 8% of our high schools contribute half of all dropouts in the country.
Right. The dropout factories.
We need to target students as early as possible. We also need to target those schools that are producing the most dropouts.
And Ed, from what you've seen in your affiliation with this or your sponsorship of this program, 26 Seconds, what works?
You know, what is unique about the 26 Seconds program is really, as Dominique was saying, it's a variety of ways of connecting with today's youth. Be it through Twitter, be it through Facebook, be it through other means of social networking or people participating in school discussions, getting communities involved in it. There's no one single factor. It's really getting our minds in a more holistic approach around reaching out to our young people and helping them understand the relevance of an education, the importance long term, and giving them a variety of ways of how do they get engaged and get exposed to that.
Gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us. Ed Rust from State Farm, Governor Bob Wise, and also Dominique Farrar. Very nice to meet you. Best
pleasure
of luck to you
mine.
And everything. It was a parent who pushed my next guest, his mother. She wanted him to learn how to be safe in the swimming pool. He brought her home 16 Olympic medals. Next.